Welcome to the third part, and I think that now I want to work on this area. Here we have many cookies and also gingerbread man. I think that for all the cookies I will be using the same color combo, and to attract more attention to the gingerbread man, for him I will invent some new colors, some new color combo. And for the cookies I can use exactly the same colors which I used for the cinnamon. Already we have used a lot of colors and picture is very detailed, so we will need a lot more of new colors ahead of us. So if it's possible, I try to limit amount of colors here. So I think that cookies can be perfectly well colored with eggshell, nectar, chestnut and chocolate. Let's start. Probably let's start with the nectar color. By varying pressure on nectar, I can get more baked cookies and less baked, so to slightly vary color, and it also can be helpful. Some of the cookies will be a little bit darker and some will be a little bit lighter. First layer is ready. Now we can slowly add some contrast with chestnut, which is a little bit darker comparing to nectar. I want to put this chestnut along this edge of the cookie, along the icing. Around these icing dots. Also here, our cookie is partly hidden behind this back. And in the corners of this cookie, of each of the squares. Maybe how it now it will be more comfortable to watch. Now we can work with a lighter color. Actually, I want to use it a little bit on the mix with nectar, and I plan to use it for some parts of the icing. Now let's move back to the nectar. It's time to blend all colors. Now it's easier for me to see where I need additional shadows. I will be using chocolate. I want to work here on this shadow between cookie and the bag. And then here in the corners to add some depth to the texture of this cookie. And probably here. I can add a little bit of deco peach, which we have already used on the candy canes. I hope that I will be able to find color text. Oh, here it is, deco. Well, it's okay for now. Later I will decide if I need some brighter color, maybe some brighter pink to add for the icing, or maybe no. It will depend from other elements on this page. For now, I'm quite satisfied with my cookies and I'm ready to go to the next element of the page. And of course, on the cookies, it's better to get rid of all the black lines, even if on pictures by T.Bogema Bogema, in black lines they are very delicate and thin, so I love how design is made, so it's quite easy to get rid of the black lines. I hate when we have a very thick black lines on the cookies, on the flowers, so everywhere where we definitely need to get rid of them, and lines can be very thick, but here it's definitely not a problem. Gingerbread man has to wait for a little bit. Now I want to work on this lower part of the Christmas stocking. Probably you remember that on the Christmas tree we have used muted turquoise, and I also want to use it somewhere here, but of course I can't color with just one pencil. Muted turquoise I intend to use here for the middle part of the remaining area of the stocking, but I need something to shade it, some darker color, and maybe cerulean blue will help me to add shadow here on the bottom part. Let's try. Let's start with muted turquoise. I need to gently blend it with the deco yellow, which I used for the highlighted area of the fabric. Here I pressed very lightly, and then in the middle I can press slightly harder to get more intense turquoise color. Honestly, I am not sure how it will work together with cerulean. I have tested it on the piece of paper, but sometimes when you start to color what worked well on the sheet of paper can be not so well on the image, so we will see. Now let's try to mix muted turquoise with cerulean blue. Looks a little bit strange, but as I need the cerulean blue for some other elements of this page, I plan to use it on the teapot. I hope that still it works also here in this area. I think that it's time to use my blender. It will help me to mix these two colors together. I don't want to add additional muted turquoise. I want to blend them with blender, and it will help me to mask white spots of the paper. For this patch, I intend to use the same red colors which we have already used for the stocking. I don't know, maybe it would look better if for this area we also used some red colors, maybe dark red like black raspberry for example. But I wanted this page to be very colorful, so that's why I decided to use totally different color palette. Let's do this patch. It's permanent red, the same as we used here in the middle part of the stocking. Then pale vermilion. And crimson lake. Now I will be coloring the remaining area of the stocking exactly in the same way, with muted turquoise on the top part, and closer to the ground I will be using cerulean blue. Thank you. Now let's color the teapot. I want to make it a white but with blue ornament, so I decided to add this line here and here on the nose and on the body of the teapot. It reminds in shape the cup. So let's start from this blue area. I will start with the cerulean blue. And where is my color tag for cerulean blue? I totally don't have any idea. Anyway, it's cerulean blue. Here I will leave uncolored area, which will represent light reflection on the glassy surface of the china. And maybe this sphere I also will color with cerulean blue. To make small shadow here, I will use denim blue. I hope that it will be a little bit darker. Probably here I want to do golden edge of the cup, so I will use artichoke. And a little bit of canary yellow. Now, difficult part. As I said, I want to leave the whole body of the teapot white, but of course, even when we color white things, we still need to show some reflections of the light, some reflections of the objects which are around this white glossy surface. So I will need to add another colors. First, I want to use denim blue to add a very light blue shading, mostly here on the left side. This side is more highlighted from this lantern, so shadow will be on the opposite side. It's a very pale color, so it's very helpful for creating shadows on the white objects. Along the lower part of the nose. Now I want to, it wasn't denim blue, sorry, it was powder blue. It's a total mess on my table because of so many tags with color names. So the next one will be gray lavender. Another very helpful color for creating shadows on white objects. Together they create a very delicate but a very beautiful shadow. And maybe we can even add a little bit of deco peach. Around we have a lot of red, orange colors, and they all will be reflecting in the white, so adding a little bit of peach can be helpful for creating realistic looking teapot. And I think that it's enough. Maybe my last color will be white to work more on these highlights. And I can check my reflection of the light from the lantern. If I lost this yellow highlights, I can add it now using deco yellow. To make this teapot to pop up, I can darken area behind it, area of the pine tree. Use whatever dark color you have. Here I grabbed my Polychromos dark indigo. Now I think that I have finished.